This morning, as we go into this series, Pastor Bob did a great job last week of how to live in the midst of ambiguity. And our anchor verse for this series is Matthew 7, 24 through 27. So you can sum that verse in your Bible. Matthew 7, 24 through 27 says this: "Everyone then who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on the rock. Rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house. But it did not fall, because it had been founded on the rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell. And great was its fall." This morning, we're going to go through a familiar passage. This is our anchor verse for the series. It's the end of the aptly named Sermon on the Mount. This morning, I want us to go through a section that you'll know is very familiar. But my goal this morning is to really open it up in a way that challenges kind of our preconceived Christian thinking. Luckily, I got a voice. There it is. Matthew chapter 5, verse 1 and 2. This will be our anchor verse today. And then we'll look at it. Matthew 5, 1 and 2. "And when Jesus saw the crowd, he went up to the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he began to speak and talk to them." Jesus, we just weren't expecting to. Holy Spirit, have your way. But you know we've prepared, we've planned for things, and we've taken your words seriously. But Jesus, we say you're in charge. God, we pray for our nation. God, bring a spirit of repentance. Lord, I ask that we would not grow comfortable in it. That Jesus, you would have an outpouring of your spirit that would be evident. The sick would be healed, as Mark said, the lyrics of that song is so powerful. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. You are sovereign King. Let every knee bow before the King of Kings. Let every heart confess that Jesus is King.
Thank you. Thank you. The world that passes as a person
But there's something with conflict. Spirit of God, Father, Spirit of Father,
Thank you.
and we're doing it all the time. And I don't know about you, but when Jesus speaks to me, all of us are going to be able to see the best of the world. I don't know about you, but I'm going to put all of you in the world. So, I'm going to put all of you in the world. The biblical message is more about your persistence in Christ, your power in Christ, your persistence in God. That's the word of God. Don't say a word for me. It is just a bad word. It's not a good word. But some of us, we have to keep it in mind. We have to keep it in mind. God's authority always exists. But if I can be a Christian, you seem to know so many believers in social media who are really mirroring and talking about you. I thought it was just a work in terms of that solution. So this last piece of glory, not carefully. Not Christian, not carefully. Yet the reality is that a biblical world can be this. I believe that there are a lot of places where question doesn't cut it from this passage. Because it's been preached before. It's an accurate, yes, it's an accurate world. But it is a wrong definition of what it is like. And the world of the same will be disaster. There are two different ways to do this. You can be a person who is not or is inside or choose to be. There's a few definitions on how Christian is used in perfect. There's more than one class of teacher. You have to have a passion for Jesus Christ. This is a question. But this is a question. What is a question? What is a question? The question is one that is perfect. What is the question? It is needed to extend to the perfect. But it is perfect to extend to the perfect. separated from you. When you come to the peace of the family, the peace of Christ, you and God are blessed. Your children are protected. You can manage peace in the midst of the family. But when you believe it, you can plan with your children. That's what it teaches you to provide. You know how to protect it and privilege and care to believe it because you're praying yourself. This is the